Hello friends, good to see you again through this video. Today I have a bottle in my hand. Okay, it's a plastic bottle and also it has a lid. The bottle has a lid. So I have kept this bottle closed. So the question today I wanted to share is, why do we keep a bottle closed? That is what I wanted to share. You know, you may think this is a very simple question. What is so great about it, right? Because we may easily come out with reasons saying like, you know, if we are not closing the bottle, if the bottle is not closed, there are chances that things that are inside the bottle could spill out, and sometimes any dust or some insects or something can go and spoil the content, you know, spoil the food that is inside the bottle, right? So that is the whole purpose, we keep it closed, right? Or to keep the food, you know, fresh, and so that it is not contaminated, it doesn't get contaminated like that. So those are all common reasons. So today, on the same lines, we are going to think about our mind also, because our mind is more like this bottle. You know, our heart or our mind is more like this bottle, where the Lord has already filled us with joy and happiness. You know, when we receive the salvation through Jesus Christ, the Bible says we receive the gift of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit comes and resides within us from that day we receive the salvation. So what happens once the Holy Spirit comes inside of us, he begins to produce the fruit of the Spirit, right? That is what we see. Galatians chapter 5 verse 20 to 23 talks about the 9 different forms in which the fruit of Spirit will exhibit in our life. Love, peace, joy, you know, self-control. There are like 9 different ways it will, you know, exhibit. It will get exhibited in our life. So when God has placed such valuable treasure in us, including the joy and happiness, so are we able to, you know, safeguard that happiness is what I have to talk today. Because many times we open our mind to so many unwanted stuff in this world, like lustful desires, or it could be worry, it could be anxieties, it could be fear. Like there are so many factors that are ready to come and torment us, ready to come and take our joy and happiness. So it is our duty to make sure that our joy, the happiness and joy that the Lord has given in our life, we have to safeguard it. So how are we going to safeguard it? And that is where this lid comes into picture, right? So the lid is nothing but Jesus Christ. Because only when our life is safe, is secured in Jesus Christ, only we are living a life that is within the Lord Jesus Christ, that is when you will be able to safeguard your joy and happiness. And for that, I wanted to share like few verses today. If you read in the book of Philippians, the letter Philippians that Paul wrote, right? If you read the chapter 4, verse 4, 6 and 7, it says like this. He's asking us to do one thing, right? Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. You know, when Paul was writing this letter, he was at the prison and he knew for sure that his end is going to come soon. You know, someday or the other, he's going to get killed. In spite of knowing that circumstances, in spite of knowing that he's going to soon be away from this world, but look at what he's saying. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. See, that is the mentality, that is the attitude that Paul wants you and me to carry in this world. Because when we allow the anxieties, right, when we allow the anxieties to come inside us, like, you know, when we allow the worldly, you know, care and like, you know, what are all the problems that we are going through, when we allow them to enter into our mind, what happens? They take away our joy, they take our peace, you know, and we become so frustrated and discouraged. But that is not the way the Lord wants you and me to live. Because it says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. See, that is what I said. You know, when we take that step of, you know, shredding all the anxiety and bringing the supplication with thanksgiving to the Lord, the peace will be there. And also it will be guarded by Jesus Christ, right? Our minds and heart will be guarded by Jesus Christ. And that is where this lid is very, very important for a bottle. So without this lid, this bottle, right? It doesn't, you know, it's not very useful because it can still like spill the content out, or anything can go inside and spoil the content that is inside this bottle. So today, my dear friends, let's think about this. Are we too worried about our circumstances? Are we too much, worried and like, you know, too much, anxious about our circumstances? It is time for us to rejoice in the Lord. There is another verse that I wanted to point. If you read in the book of Habakkuk, chapter 3, verse 17 and 18, this is what that prophet says. Though the fig tree should not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, the produce of the olive fail, and the fields yield no food, the flock be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will take joy in the God of my salvation. See what he's saying. Even though things are going against me, even though what I expected didn't happen in my life, even though I had to endure a loss, he says, I will still rejoice in the Lord because He is the Lord of my salvation, which means He knows how to redeem me. He knows how to save me from a situation. So today, that is the biggest question you and I we have. Are we allowing our hearts and minds to be guarded by Jesus Christ? Because when we don't do that, we will expose ourselves to this, to all this anxiety, fear, and the discouragement, and anything for that matters, anything that the Satan wants to bring in our life to rob our peace and happiness, we get exposed ourselves, you know, when we don't have Jesus Christ as our Savior and as our Lord. So today, rejoice in the Lord always, no matter what your circumstances look like, no matter how bad your situation look like. Take time, you know, thank the Lord because He is always good. And even in the midst of a tight situation, even in the midst of a crisis, God can still bring you out, and He will eventually work all things for your good, because that is what this verse says, right? So you and I, we can be assured that when we rejoice in the Lord, no matter what the circumstances look like, the Lord of the salvation will be our helper. May the Lord bless this word. You all have a blessed and a happy day. God bless you.